Thank you. as well as the online audience watching from afar. I will speak to you in English, since I know we have online guests from China and America and every little place on planet Earth, I think. I hope so. At any rate, the first piece we played was Bach's Harpsichord Concerto in B minor, the first movement. And we had the amazing soloists, Bouyer and Alisa. This was the more classical part of the concert, so to speak, the conventional classical. Now we will continue with a local piece, a homegrown Aalborg piece, so to speak, because we have a dear friend and composer in the audience, Luis Aguirre, who has written this fantastic work in five movements, five so to speak miniature movements, each with their own life and inspired by paintings and musical ideas and memories. And for those of you who know Luis Aguirre, I should say that he likes to operate in extremes, yes. Very, very loud sections, for instance, maybe this is your favorite extreme, and then also sometimes very soft sections. This piece has also a little bit of everything, and I mean, we enjoy this piece very much, and it's a sort of, let's call it an educational piece for us percussionists, because Luis's music is often very, very complex with unimaginable polyrhythms that have to be executed at the same time as other polyrhythms and crazy tonalities and chords. And this piece is a little bit more subdued and let's say a little bit more approachable. So without further ado, the DKDM percussion ensemble will perform Luis Aguirre's Preludios y Toccatas. Thank you. Thank you. is for percussion quintet, and it's written by the Greek New Zealand composer John Tsatsas. And it's a piece inspired by a famous solo by Keith Jarrett, the American jazz pianist. And John Tsatsas has sort of elaborated on this solo and of course orchestrated it for percussion ensemble. And you'll hear many contrasting sections. It's a very rhythmical piece with changing meters, very groovy. And for the first time in the concert, we will have what is very typically found in a percussion concert. We will have some drums, so you won't be cheated for that. Also, during the piece, our dear Toby Rasmussen will be playing the marimba with a double bass bow, which produces this sort of it's a sound that is almost impossible to believe that it's produced by an acoustic instrument. It sounds almost electronic, and it's a very beautiful sound, very soulful. So listen for that. And also we will have the Glockenspiel, and so we have a few more instruments in play. We hope you enjoy Kyoto by John Tsatsas. Thank you. style, which Piazzolla is most famous for, the Tango Nuevo, and I've tried to arrange it for percussion octet, which in a way is a challenge, because usually in the tango quintets, for instance, of Piazzolla's time, Piazzolla's own quintets, you always have the double bass, like really rhythmical, very strong fundament under the ensemble. And the marimba bass is certainly also very nice, but it doesn't have the same prominent fundamentals as the double bass. So most of the piece we had Frederick and Tano in tandem, so to speak, playing the bass part to give the strong fundamentals under the orchestra. And then another instrument coming to the tango is the violin, carrying the beautiful heartbreaking melodies. And we attempt to do this on the mostly the vibraphones, but also on the marimbas. So it of course becomes something else, but it's still very percussive, very rhythmically driving. Yeah, and we've tried to simulate some of the Piazzolla's sound effects, such as the sort of screaming or crying sounds of the violin will be produced with the special pitch bend of the rubber mallets on the vibraphone, so you can listen to that. And yeah, I will. Everybody's ready to play, so I will not talk anymore. I hope you enjoyed the last two pieces of the concert, Fugata and Tangata by Astor Piazzolla.
Thank you. Thank you.
some more drums. Okay, so we have prepared a little encore for you that I hope you will enjoy. We will just set the stage ready for the encore, and then we will thank you all for coming, especially those of you who managed to come live. The classical music obviously thrives with a live audience, and if people come to the concerts, it is much better. So thank you very much for coming and taking time out of a busy work week to come here to listen to us and to log on online in your homes and listen to our music. We've obviously been working very hard to prepare this for a little summer tour, and hope to see you again in the future, live and online. So
I'll get out of the way.
Thank you.